Hi everyone. So this is a analysis of OPSC 2023. So this year's OPSC prelims was on the tougher side. The cutoff is going to be very low, and most importantly, if you look at the whole paper, if you do an analysis, it was a fact-heavy paper and polity-heavy paper. Nonetheless, there were some questions of economy, some questions of geography, some questions of environment was there. Apart from that, we also observed, just like last year, there was some, you know, questions related to public policy. By and large, it was, will be categorized as the difficult paper till date, and the cutoff is going to be very low. We also found a couple of invalid questions, and there were some questions which have dual answers, and through this analysis, let's explore what the cutoff is going to be. So let's begin. Question number one. Which of the following statements are correct in respect of Election Commission of India? If you look at the statements, first statement, it is an autonomous legal body. It is not a legal body. We know that it's a constitutional body. So statement one is wrong. And as I told you before, couple of questions we have dual answer. Here, A and D, both of them are similar in nature, and both of them can be the answer. We have asked this question. We have covered Election Commission in depth in our classes, as well as test series may be bahut sare cover hua Election Commission ke bare mein, because election aa raha hai and it is going to be in the news all the time. So yes, moving on. Question number two, direct question hai, related to Nyaya Panchayat, and which committee recommended it? The answer is Ashok Mehta committee. In our polity extra test series, 1 year ka current affair ka test series mein, we gave this question. Question number three, Attorney General, again, that is an important chapter in our polity books. We gave this question, I think, polity test 1, 2 mein hai. Okay. Classes mein to hai hi, test series mein bhi hai. Attorney General of India is part of Indian judiciary. See, Attorney General of India does not deliver justice. He is not a judge, he is just a lawyer who is fighting on behalf of his client, and the client here being the government of India. So obviously he is not part of Indian judiciary. That you should remember. Little bit of a tricky question. So statement one is wrong. Statement two is obviously wrong, because he is not appointed on the advice of Chief Justice of India. So that leaves us with statement three and statement four. So answer is D, 3 and 4. Moving on, it is a question about bills introduced in parliament. If you look at option number, statement number 1, if a government bill is rejected by a house in parliament, it amounts to vote of confidence. No, it amounts to vote of no confidence. So statement 1 is wrong. The government's bill introduced in the house necessitates a 15-day notice. No, it necessitates a 7-day notice. So statement 1 and statement 2, both of them are wrong. That leaves us with the answer, that is C, 3 and 4. Question number 5. If you look at the question, I didn't ask this question in our test series, in any of our test series, to be honest. But I have discussed about different kinds of majority in depth, whatever, you know, the kinds of majority that is available in our constitution in depth in our polity classes. Okay. So I can say ki it is covered in our polity classes, but not in our test series. If you look at all the options, the correct option will be D, 1, 2, 3, 4. Question number 6, okay. Achha, if you look at the question, there was a special session was there for parliament, and a lot of debate and discussion was going on around it. That point of time, Indian Express mein ek editorial aaya tha, and that editorial link also I have gave in this particular discussion. See, in that particular editorial, they are giving you this particular data. Okay, the whole question is picked out from this particular editorial from Indian Express. And the problem here is the dates and the fact-heavy nature of this particular question. There is no logic we can apply whatsoever to eliminate and reach at a correct option. So this is a question, even if you have read the editorial, you will tend to miss the or get the right answer out of it. Okay. Nonetheless, answer is C, 1 and 2. Question number 7. This question is about procedure established by law and due process of law. I have elaborately discussed it in our a series discussions. I think PT01 quality test mein hai ye, due process of law. Then I went ahead and discussed the whole thing. If you look at statement number 3 given in the question, procedure established by law is an American doctrine and due process of law is an Indian doctrine. No, due process of law is an American doctrine. Okay, so statement 3 is wrong and 1 and 2 were correct. So option B is the correct option. Question number 8, you can simply apply our common sense and get the answer. If you look at the question, the answer will be pressure groups A. Question number 9. Public policy cycle, does the government explore potential policy responses? The answer will be at the stage of policy formulation. Again, this is purely common sense, although it sounds like public administrative, public art question, but no, it is not that. Common sense lagage, we can get the answer. Simple question. Question number 10, the final 6 months of election cycle when the government announces popular government initiative is known as, I think it is called Red June, because once model code of conduct lagu ho jata hai, uske baad, government cannot do anything. Okay. So prior to this, there will be Red June, I think. So question number 10, answer is C. Question number 11, which of the following are features of good governance? Easy question, apply your common sense, your whatever the thing that you have read over the years. If you see, accountability, transparency, integrity are the tenets of or features of good governance. So answer is D145. Question number 12, it is asking about public policy. If you read all the statements, all of the statements are correct and they deal with public policy. So this is a question kind of sounds like public art question. Okay. Question number 12, answer is D. Question number 13, okay, Article 21 of Indian Constitution. If you look at all the answers, let's look at statement number 2. Narmada Bachao Andolan versus Union of India 2020. Narmada Bachao Andolan bahut purana hai. Okay, so on the basis of the year only, 2020, we can eliminate that option saying that it's not a correct statement at all. So 2 is wrong on the basis of 2020. That much is enough to eliminate that statement. The Supreme Court also held that access to clear water is a natural right. What is clear water? We know that clean water, is kind of, is one thing, but what is clear water? So obviously, statement 4 on the particular wording clear, and statement 2 on the particular year that they have mentioned, 2020, on that basis we can eliminate them. So we are left with the answer, that is A, 1 and 3. Question number 14, easy question, quality test mein, class mein, test series mein, when you start reading quality, you will read about these things. So obviously, suspension of fundamental rights during emergency comes from Weimar Constitution of Germany. We have borrowed it from Germany. Look at question number 15, it is about right to education. Statement 1 is correct, definitely correct. Statement 2, if you look at it, it says that it was passed by the Indian Parliament on August 4, 2019. Okay. Statement 3, if you see, says that it came into force in November 14, 2009. If either of them are wrong, okay, either 3 is wrong or 2 is wrong. Most probably 3 is wrong, because if August 2009 mein ek law pass hota hai, to create that whole architecture to implement everything takes time. It cannot happen in a democracy, cannot happen in a, say, in 2 months of time. So, and it is a countrywide, implementation has to be there. So yes, you need to prepare the architecture, so many things are there. So itni jaldi nahi hoga kabhi. So that logic you can apply over here. And if you are a serious aspirant, then you must be knowing that certain constitutional amendments are holy or sacred. You have to remember them with the year. One of them is 86 Constitutional Amendment Act 2002, not 2004. So eliminate 3 and 4 and you have your answer B, 1 and 2. Question number 16. Which of the following are related to right to privacy? This is a question you cannot answer. And one thing is, we are unable to remember all the things that is there in our constitution. Itna bada constitution hai. Do we have the time, or it is humanly impossible to remember, the article numbers of declaration of human rights, all that is mentioned in our European Convention on Human Rights, possibly nahi hai. So this is a question which is bordering on, you know, say, I'll not go there, but yeah, answer is all of the above, but this is a question should not be asked. Okay, moving on, question number 17. Again, this year they had an obsession with Universal Declaration of Human Rights. Again, similar kind of question, article ke baare mein pooch rahe hai. Who will remember the article number of, you know, Universal Declaration of Human Rights? Nonetheless, I can tell you that these articles, they have not picked it up randomly. Sedition news pe tha, refugee crisis, human rights issue, bahut sara news pe tha, bahut sara editorial hub came up. So whenever anyone, you know, writing a good editorial, they will definitely quote Universal Declaration of Human Rights, ye kehta hai, wo kehta hai, and all that. So if you are someone who reads newspaper daily, you will be able to at least recall that it is, you know, Article 15 of Universal Declaration of Human Rights. Okay. Question number 17, answer is A. Question number 18. If you look at the statement 1, May 2016, RBI Act 1934 was amended. Yes. See, 2016 May RBI Act 1934 was amended to create something called Monetary Policy Committee. And its sole job is to go for, you know, inflation targeting. So it is a statutory framework to target the inflation, and the job is given to MPC or Monetary Policy Committee. And this particular statement was there in our Rectify series, April 2023 Rectify series mein hai. And if you look at option statement number 3, it talks about the threshold of inflation when the central bank will intervene. We know that it is 4% plus or minus 2. That means if the inflation goes below 2% or above 6%, then RBI or any central bank, or the Indian central bank, that is RBI, is bound to intervene. Okay, so statement 3 is wrong, 1 and 2 is correct. So on that basis you can have your answer. Question number 19, G20 New Delhi declaration. See, before exam I gave some 60-65 page document diya tha maine. Only 60, I think not 60 items also, I think 30-40 items might be, you know, given in that particular document. I have gave the screenshot of those documents. Okay, that covers this particular, you know, G20 New Delhi declaration, and the exact statements were given. If you see all 83 paragraphs of 2023, if you see over here in that, you know, screenshot also, in that material that we have given, all 83 paragraphs, that statement is there. Statement 3 wala jo $4 trillion hai clean energy ke liye by 2030, that is also there. New Delhi declaration mein already mentioned hai. So 1 and 3 is definitely right. 2 is wrong because it did talk about Ukraine. We didn't condemn Russia, but we did talk about, you know, Ukraine. So that aspect or that makes statement 2 wrong. So answer is 1 and 3. Question number 20, it is asking about MNREGA and how it is related to sustainable development goals. But one rider here is directly, they are not asking ki, you know, just whether they are related to SDG or not. In that way, everything will be related to SDG. But they are asking which of them are directly related to sustainable development goals. And again, it is very peculiar to this particular review, and according to that review, what is the outcome? Okay, it's not your opinion. They are asking of, you know, what is written in that review. So if you see, this was there in the ma'am's class discussion, I think, current affair class discussion mein cover hua hai. I didn't give this particular question in the test series though. Okay, if you see over here, SDG 1, SDG 5, SDG 10, they were directly linked with, you know, MNREGA, but zero hunger was not directly linked with MNREGA. So answer is 1, 3, 4. Covered in ma'am's class, but not given in test series. Question number 21. Poverty line estimation in India has been based on consumption expenditure and not on income levels. This is a correct statement. And statement 2, you know, see, we cannot know the income level of a daily wage laborer or of a person who is self-employed, that kind of thing. So obviously, we cannot have accurate estimation of poverty. That's why we go after consumption level. And if you look at all the options, out of that, B is the perfect answer for you. Okay. Also, this was there in the editorial smetha, and I think ma'am has covered in her classes. Multidimensional poverty index and then consumption based poverty estimates have relevance. You know, ek editorial ka headline tha, and then she went ahead and discussed, you know, what exactly, how it is different from income level wala, you know, income level mein kya restraints ya constraint hai, and all that she has discussed. Okay, doable question, easy question, and expected question. Poverty is a question they usually ask all the time. 22. If you look at the question that is given by UPSC, and if you look at the question that has been asked in our test series, they are, you know, like clone of each other. Theek hai? Option A was almost similar. Okay. So here the answer is all of them are, you know, associated with Forex. Moving on. 23. PM Vishwakarma. Again, covered as part of ma'am's current affairs classes. That was there. Apart from that, apply a little bit of common sense. For example, the scheme's name is Prime Minister Vishwakarma. Why the president will launch it? What is the last time you saw a major scheme being launched by President of India? Almost never. So option A is the wrong one. 24. It's a very interesting question. If you look at it, it is about GST. Okay, the statement one says that GST is based on a system of concurrency of indirect taxes. Yes. See, GST is the only tax that was for the first time in Indian constitution was put under concurrent list. If you see that question I gave in our test series, and I explained, you know, in that discussion video that GST is in concurrent list. So that makes statement one right. Then another question that I gave in our test series that talks about, you know, the statement two, that is GST replaced production based taxation system by consumption based taxation system. That means GST is a destination tax. Okay, jahan pe destination mein jayega wahan hoga tax taxation. Okay, production ke upar nahi. So statement 2 is correct. Also, destination principle for cross border trading. Yahan pe kya ho raha hai? Suppose somebody has produced something in Gujarat and selling it to say Jharkhand. Okay, so the Jharkhand people, the consuming states will benefit from the transaction. That is what the whole idea of, you know, GST is. So all of the statements are correct. Question number 25. Production linked incentive scheme. This question I have asked in our test series, PT11 economy test mein pucha gaya tha. Discussion video mein bhi hai is. The scheme is applicable. If you look at option number D, statement number D. The scheme is applicable only to pharmaceuticals, textile, food processing. No, if you look here, it is applicable to 14 sectors. So obviously, why we limit it to few sectors only? So that's what makes the makes it a wrong statement. Moving on, question number 26. NABARD, easy question, doable question. If you look at the read all the options, you know that the correct option is A. Providing refinance to lending institution in rural area. That is the most important duty of NABARD. 27. Okay. Now, if you have not read this particular editorial, came in say Indian Times in this particular date, there is a high degree, you know, chance that you will end up going for option C instead of option B. Okay, because ye ek news pe tha, Indian female infant mortality ratio is now equal to male infant mortality ratio, which is a very rare phenomenon. Okay, but that makes option B is the correct option. 28. Gas. Okay, it is asking about global warming or greenhouse gases. If you look at the option, the correct option is C. In our PPT 04 claims preparedness test 04, we gave all the greenhouse gases and, you know, asked which of them are exactly greenhouse gases. Carbon monoxide or greenhouse gas, again, on that basis you can arrive at the answer. 28 C is the answer. Okay, nitrogen fixing bacteria mostly leguminous plant ke root mein rehte hain. Oat is not one of them. Easy question, doable question. 29 D is the answer. 30. Okay. See, here they are playing with the years. I gave this question, although I mentioned in a particular test, in our test series, I gave this question and gave the proper years. So here, if you see, Water Act 1974, Environment Protection Act 1986, Biodiversity Act 2002, Air Act 1981. Anyone worth their, you know, name as an aspirant knows or you know by heart these things, because without remembering all these things you cannot go to the exam. So it is a doable topic. Environment class mein to cover hota hi hai. In our test series also I gave this one, and 30 the answer is A, doable easy question. Government, okay. Question number 31, it is asking about the biodiversity heritage sites or BHS sites of Odisha. If you look here, it is asking you know which of the pairs are not correct. Okay. Mandasur Gorge is a biodiversity heritage site, but it is located in Kandhamal. Covered in current affairs classes, ma'am's current affairs classes, ye to hai. Okay. Apart from that, in our test series also, UPSC test series, I gave this question. Mandasur, Mahindragir, Gandhamal, then Gadjat. So, that is there. And in explanation, I gave that ki Mandasur kahan pe hai, Mahindragir kahan pe hai, Gandhamal then kahan pe hai, no. The issue here is, Satkoshiya Gorge is not a biodiversity heritage site. So, B is wrong, not correct, as well as C is not correct, because Satkoshiya Gorge is not a biodiversity heritage site yet. We have only three. So, that makes this particular question invalid, in my opinion. Question number 32. The question is asking about globally important agricultural heritage systems. If you have read your environment well, and in my classes I have mentioned it n number of times, that Koraput as a region has a you know very interesting biodiversity, and we have somewhere around more than 1000 you know rice varieties if you look at undivided KBK. Okay, so it is from the global perspective, it is a important agricultural heritage system. And this was declared by FAO in 2012. Didn't give it in our test series, but environment class mein I have covered it. 32D. 33. Okay, Project Tiger to news pe tha hai. Bahut sare question aaye the Project Tiger mein. We are also expecting a question on International Big Cat Alliance and all that. They didn't ask that. Anyway, so if you look at the question, ma'am's current affairs class, this was there in the you know covered. Dholpur Karoli became the Rajasthan's fifth tiger reserve. Now the question is asking you know does not include tiger reserve established in the year 1973. If you know ki Dholpur Karoli abhi abhi bana hai, obviously you can eliminate it easily. Okay, 33 answer will be B. 34, marine protected area. If you look here, I gave the question in our test series PT05 geography test mein diya tha maine marine protected area ke bare mein. We talk about you know arranging Gahirmatha, Pulikat, Koringa, Point Kalima, these are all marine protected areas of India. Periyar in Kerala is not a marine protected area. Periyar is a river. Okay, so it's not a marine protected area. Moving on, 35. 35 is asking about Rio Earth Summit, okay, and which of the statements are correct. If you look here, if you look at statement 3 exactly, representative from 79 countries participated in the conference. We know that ki, if you read it properly, representative of 179 countries participated. Iska, I gave the question and its explanation mein maine bataya tha ki, 179 countries have you know participated in it. So if you eliminate 3, you have your answer 1 and 2. 35 answer is A. Moving on, 36. This is a very peculiar question. It is asking about Microsoft, and since when Microsoft became you know carbon neutral. The answer is 2012, but then again I don't know why they asked this question. 37, World Environment Day. We used to remember, you know, only 1 year's theme. Now you have to remember, you know, 4 years' theme. if you look at the all the options, 2020, time for, it was, the theme was time for nature, not time for environment. So answer is, the question is asking which is not correct. So obviously D is the correct option here. Okay. I gave this particular test, but I only covered 2023 World Environment Day. Kya tha? Simple question, I didn't expect much of it. But they have asked, you know, combined four years and then they asked. So 37, answer is D. Moving on, 38. 1 light year is equivalent to how many kilometers? See, we are expecting question on Chandrayaan. So many things have happened in, say, Gaganyaan is happening, Chandrayaan is happening. So many things have been happening in the space sector. and we gave a lot of questions on space sector, very interesting questions as well. We can expect them to come in or appear in UPSC exam next year, pretty sure. But only thing that UPSC has asked is, what is a 1 light year? Okay, again, the answer is 9.5 trillion kilometers. That is the only close relative question related to space sector. This another one is there. Jet fuel in aviation engine mainly consists of, the answer is kerosene, 39C. Light emitting diode is made up of GaN, gallium arsenide, I think. So answer is C, 40C. 41, meniscus rise in glass thermometer due to the change in density. Okay, answer is density. See, till now I haven't seen the science and tech portion of UPSC evolving too much. Okay, the way they are asking the questions of science and tech related questions in UPSC, and if you compare that with UPSC last time, mains maybe other than that, it's not a question. Okay, some from somewhere, you know, they are picking some book and then asking something. Doesn't make any sense. Okay, anyway, moving on. 41, answer is A. 42, tap water, distilled water, sea water, which one will be the first one to get solidified? See, lesser the impurity, higher the solidification. So distilled water is the purest one, will solidify faster. Then tap water, kuch impurity hai, sea water, pura impurity hai. So isi ke hisab se 42 answer is D. Consider the following regarding revolt of 1857. Indore troops had joined the revolt against the wish of their king. Mangal Pandey was executed at Meerut. Mangal Pandey was in Barakpur, and he was executed over there. So statement 2 is wrong. Rest of the statements are correct. So answer is 1, 3, 4. Answer is A. Moving on, question number 44. Ramesh Chandra Dutt. This is a difficult question, and they are asking so much of teeny tiny details of about a particular person. Modern India to SI factory, they are asking this kind of question. So anybody with history optional may be able to do it, but I am not certain that they will go after this particular question. This is the question. Better agar chhod do yaar. Okay, all of the statements are correct though. 45, Home Rule League ke baare mein question hai. It is asking about, statement 1 is Subramanyam Iyer and Anil Vaishan. Both of them were in Chennai. We know that Anil Vaishan Chennai mein tha, RDR mein. So both of them most probably associate of each other. It started on behalf of Indian National Congress. Nahi, it was never that. In fact, Indian leaders of Indian National Congress joined Home Rule League. Okay. It changed its name to Swaraj Sabha. Yes, this is correct, and we gave this in our test series. Prelims preparedness test 05, question number 25 mein ye tha. Gandhi accepted the presidency of All India Home Rule League in 1920. That's a correct statement. Home Rule League changed its name to Swaraj Sabha. That is a correct statement. So 1 is definitely correct, 3 is definitely correct, 2 is definitely wrong. You have your answer, 45C. 46, again every year we expect questions related to landforms every year, and हर बार टेस्ट में क्लास में तो डिस्कशन होता ही है. इफ यू लुक एट द आंसर इज सी 3421. ओके, मूविंग ऑन. 47, स्कैंडिनेवियन कंट्रीज हैव ए रिग्रेसिव एज सेक्स पॉपुलेशन स्ट्रक्चर. द पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ रेट इज नेगेटिव इन दिस कंट्रीज. सी, पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ रेट विल बी नेगेटिव इन ए कंट्री. सी, दिस इज अ काइंड ऑफ लिटिल बिट ज्योग्राफी ऑप्शनल वाला क्वेश्चन. ठीक है, ह्यूमन ज्योग्राफी ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, दैट काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन. ओके, if you look at the countries with a negative population growth rate, the only countries that I can think of is couple of are there though. Most important them will be Russia, Japan. These are the two countries. Why? Because their death rate is more than birth rate, first. Second, they are not allowing, or they have a very tight border policy. That means they have a tight immigration policy. Because of that, they are not allowing others to settle in. But Scandinavian countries, they are allowing Indians, others to move there and settle in. So Scandinavia, even if the birth death rate little bit skewed because of immigration, their population growth rate is not negative. Okay. So here answer will be C. Again, 48. ये बचपन वाला क्वेश्चन है. आर्कटिक रीजन एस्किमो ऑब्वियसली. डिजर्ट में वी नो की करावन है. डिजर्ट करावन बी फोर. देन यू हैव योर आंसर. 48 बी इज द आंसर. ओके ब्यूटीफुल क्वेश्चन. 49 दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम यू नो फ्रॉम एनसीईआरटी. आई थिंक एनसीईआरटी का फिजिकल ज्योग्राफी का क्वेश्चन है. आई डोंट नो व्हाट इज द ऑब्सेशन विद कोपेन. दे हैव आस्क्ड टू क्वेश्चंस ऑन कोपेन दिस ईयर. एनीवे we cover this as part of our geography classes, but मैं test series में ये सब पूछता नहीं. ठीक है. If I ask, then students will get angry also. That too is true. But anyway, if you look at the question, 49A is the answer. Okay. If you know, remember this, well and good. If you don't, leave it and move on. Question number 50. Okay. Easy question, eh? Because if you look at the question, the Peru desert is recognized as a cold desert. Yes. And it is cold because of that Peru Humboldt current is, you know, playing over there. So that's why. So 50A is the answer. Geography class mein cover hai, I think test mein bhi hoga. Okay, kahin na kahin, definitely. 51. Over here, this is little bit, you know, deeper into Indian geography. Because it is talking about race and where they are settling, etc. Okay, let's look at it. Indo-Aryan. If you look at Indo-Aryan, they are mostly settled in. That means we are talking about Vedic age people. If you have read your ancient India, you will know that they have initially settled in Rajasthan, Punjab region. Okay, Rajasthan and Punjab region. Then baad mein in later Vedic age, they will move to Gangetic Valley. Okay. So, Indo-Aryans, we can assign it to Rajasthan and Punjab. Scytho-Dravidians, we can assign it to Karnataka. Mongolo-Dravidians, we can assign it to Odisha and Assam. Okay. Because Mongol-Dravidian, who is close to, you know, Mongolia? Odisha and Assam people, not Karnataka and Gujarat people. So that's why we can, that logic we can apply and find the answer. Okay, for 51 answer is A. The question is specifically asking about which of the statements are not correct. If you look at Bajra, it is a kharif crop. That much rainfall and temperature is required. Cotton, we know that long, medium, short staple cotton is there. If you have read Indian history during World War II time, okay, American cotton used to compete with, you know, Indian cotton because their cotton was long staple cotton. Okay, but Indian had short staple cotton. So, if you read your history, you will be able to know that as well. Currently, India accounts for about 50% of world's total jute production. That is also correct. So, only incorrect, not correct is one is the statement 4. So, answer 52, answer is D. 53. In MAMS current affairs class, Sardar Sarovar Narmada project is there, and we know that Sardar Sarovar project is in the lower Narmada valley and feeds or helps, you know, Gujarat. So if you have that answer, that Sardar Sarovar project, lower Narmada valley, B1, you have your answer here. You don't need to think about anything else. If you know B1, you have your answer. That's it. 53, answer is C. 54, Sipkila, you know, places and the passes. Again, current affairs classes may cover by Agil Pass, Sipkila, Jalepla, Dipu Pass. So, ma'am, the current affairs class may cover by. Apart from that, I gave this in test series also. Okay, Agil Pass, Dipu Pass, ye sab ne pucha tha. Usual question hai, expected question hai, usually aata hai. 55. Interesting question. See. Statement 2, it is a question about monsoon, breaks in monsoon. That means the meaning of breaks in monsoon is that monsoon has a dry spell and wet spell. That is because, see, monsoon is mostly carried out by something called monsoon trough. A trough is nothing but an elongated, low pressure system. Now, when that low pressure system moves northward towards Himalaya, we'll have a dry spell. When it moves southward, we'll have a wet spell. That's the whole nature of our monsoon, and because it keeps on moving upward or downward, northward or southward, accordingly we'll have a dry spell or wet spell. Right. Now let's look at the options. Origin of tropical cyclone Bay of Bengal. Yes. If Bay of Bengal mein bahut zyada cyclone ho raha hai, that means that low pressure system will help this monsoon trough or monsoon elongated low pressure system bulge up or bulk up. So we'll have a very good rainfall. So statement 1 is correct. Erratic behavior of second equatorial crew. I don't understand what is second, what is third, what is fourth. We have only one monsoon crew in that whole monsoon period. It keeps on moving up over, upward and downward. So that statement I am not aware of. So I'll not go for it. Okay. Statement 2 is wrong. Inadequate heating of Tibetan plateau. See, Tibet, Himalaya, then we have Tibetan plateau. Tibetan plateau mein kya hai this point of time? We have warm but anti-cyclonic system. Okay. Anti-cyclonic system hai. And that's how it is related to Indian monsoon. If you look at statement 4, southern branch of southwest tropical jet re-established over northern India. That is correct. Okay, dry spell, yeah, wet spell, uski wajah se hoga. So, 1 and 4 is correct, rest of them are wrong. 2 and 3 are wrong, in my opinion. Okay. 56, antecedent drainage pattern in Odisha. Okay. That means landscape is new, the drainage is old. That's the whole scene here. And if you look here, that means if a river is powerful enough, then and only then they can resist the changes of the landscape and still, you know, still dominate the landscape. If you look at the strong rivers over here, Mahanadi and Brahmani are stronger than any other river, combination of the rivers over here. That's why 56A, they are the antecedent drainage pattern in Odisha. Geography class mein cover hota hai hamara Odisha geography. Black earth soil has been developed in which region of Odisha? Although I didn't ask this question particularly, I have asked about soils in Odisha in our that particular test series, PT-14 Odisha test. Now, I gave the map, Kahan-kahan-be black soil, all that thing is there. Apart from that, I have asked this particular question about, you know, in which, I have asked this question about in our test series about Odisha, that in which part of Odisha we grow cotton. And we all know that if we want to grow cotton, we need to have black soil. Okay. If you look at the option, A, B is completely out of question. C is bit tricky. Angul, Atmalik, we have black soil, both many. Okay. So that's the tricky part. Sambalpur Valley, so is a safer option. Answer is D, Sambalpur Valley. If you look at that particular test at Uskapura, if you go through the solutions, that whole detail is there. 58. Interesting, upland and, you know, the rivers associated with it. I gave this question in our test series as well, although I didn't give exact question. Question number 58, interesting, Odisha geography again, covered in our classes, test may be covered by Rajgang, Purpanpur, upland, all the uplands and the rivers originating from there. If you look at here, look over here, answer is A, 4123. Similar kind of question has been given in our test series. 59, Chilka Lake. Okay, it is the first Indian wetland, we know that. It's the first Ramsar site of India, Irrawaddy Dolphin, to pata hai hai. Lacustrine plain, that means a plain created because of the deposits by the lake. Yes, Chilka Lake is doing that, so all of them are correct. Odisha geography class mein cover up. Odisha experiences which types of climates according to Köppen's climatic classification. Doesn't matter who is classifying Odisha's, you know, climate, it's going to remain the same. Okay. Whether it is Köppen or some other climatologist. The answer is tropical savanna. 61. Objective resolution. We gave this in our polity test class to discussion why it is one of the important parts also. Obviously, Ambedkar was not the author of, you know, objective resolution. बाद में जो जाके ट्रेम्बल बना. सो वन इज रॉन्ग, फोर इज राइट. यू हैव योर आंसर 61B. 62, नॉट अच्छा आर करेक्ट इन रेस्पेक्ट ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट असेंबली. दिस इज, यू नो, द वेरी बिगिनिंग ऑफ चैप्टर्स ऑफ योर पॉलिटी बुक. आंसर इज डी, 1 and 3. 63, अगेन पॉलिटी क्लास में टेस्ट में डिस्कशन हुआ है. आंसर इज, what is the source and what are the things we, you know, we brought those things from. Okay, so answer is 63D. Okay, that's the correct one. 64. See, this is a doubtful and this particular question can be contested. Why? Because Article 12 and Article 36, how they are related and how they are not related, both can be argued. And same goes for, you know, other articles. And most importantly, who will remember all these articles and what this, you know, all these articles entail? So it's like, you know, they are not trying to recruit civil servants, but they are trying to recruit, you know, paralegals. Okay. So it's a bad question in my opinion. 65. Which of the following statements are correct in respect of lame duck politician? Answer is 1, 2, 4. Okay. 66. It is about basic structure. Polity class mein test mein cover hua hai. It is a form of judicial review. We all know that it used to test the legality of any legislation by the It is used to test the legality of any legislation by the courts. Yes. The doctrine of basic structure, constitution gave a free hand. No, not at all. The constitution of India defines, no, it does not define what is basic structure. We find out the basic structure through the Supreme Court, various Supreme Court judgments. Okay. Constitution does not speak about it. So answer is A, 1 and 2. We gave this in our test series class, maybe the A. 67, this is again. I don't understand what they are, you know, trying to hire here. Civil servants or paralegals? Because this kind of question, who will remember? Entry 5 of list 2 of 7 schedule. See, when we are living in the age where data is so readily available, what's the point of having, you know, asking data as a, you know, question? And this is very specific one. Entry 5 of list 12, list 2 of 7 schedule. Answer is local governments, but then again, I will categorize this question as unintelligent, irrational and out of touch. 68, similar kind of question. If you look at the statement 3, 243i, it deals with taxation, no doubt about it, but it does not talk about the levying power of panchayats, but not giving power to the power of taxation to the panchayats. Okay, that you should remember. That's why that statement is wrong. If they, instead of levy, they have used distribute, that statement would have been right. If you see, answer will be 1 and 2. 68, 1 and 2. Again, this question is something that you should leave, not attend at all. Can go either way. Achha. 69 is about G20 developing nations. G20 and G20 developing nations are two different phenomena. First, understand that, then we'll go into discussion of this particular question. It is a block of developing nations established on 2001. No, it was established in 2003. The group emerged at the 5th Ministerial NATO Conference. Nahi, wrong statement hai. Headquarter Patna mein hai, correct. And member states of G20 is 20 countries. Nahi, 23 members. So, 1 is wrong, 2 is wrong, 4 is wrong. And the question is asking which of them are not correct. Then the answer should have been 1, 2, 1, 4. But we don't have that, so it is an invalid question. So, if you have done it wrong, thinking that G20 ka question da kharab kar diya, nahin. It was not about G20 at all. And if you have done it wrong also, no need to worry, it's an invalid question. So, be happy now. Question number 70. When our Prime Minister visited Australia, he talked about 3C, 3D and 3E. Okay, common sense or kuch nahi. Okay, Commonwealth, cricket, curry or kya hi ho sakta hai. 71, Senegal was in the news, so much hue and cry and debate, all that was there. Statement 2 agar dekhoge, it symbolizes Marathi culture, nahi, Tamil culture. Statement 4 agar dekhoge, we are not concerned ki when it was given and which time to pronounce Jawaharlal Nehru. But it talks about the Adhinam of Kerala. Nahin, it came from Tamil Nadu again. So on that ground, safe, if you know that it was from Tamil Nadu, 2 and 4 both of them become wrong statement. So you are left with, you know, A as the answer, 1 and 3. Okay, we gave this question in our test series 2. Wonders of the Week series, current affairs ke MCQ mein diya gaya tha. Also, ma'am has elaborately discussed this in her current affairs classes. 72, achha, 2000 currency notes. If you look at the question, didn't give in our test series, na important nahi laga. Part of the answer here is D, 1 and 4. Okay. Moving on, 73, Forex Plus 2.0. This is a question, this is thoda purana hai, 2019. So if you are a person who has been preparing since 2019, you might be knowing this one. Otherwise, there is very slim chance. The answer here is C, 1 and 3. 74. Euxine Sea. Okay. The sea is also known as Red Sea. No, that is the incorrect statement. And that is the correct answer here. Because Euxine Sea is Black Sea. 75. The first ever, first census of water bodies in India. Okay. The census enumerated total of this much of water bodies. Okay. West Bengal has highest number of tanks. West Bengal does not have much tanks. In fact, jahan pe we find tanks where we have, you know, enough water scarcity. For example, Deccan region mein we find tank. Hyderabad mein, Telangana region mein, all that places we find, you know, tank irrigation. West Bengal we will find a lot of ponds, reservoirs, no tanks. Tamil Nadu has highest number of lakes, yes. Andhra Pradesh leads in water conservation schemes. So, the pata nahi, Tamil Nadu correct hai and statement 1 is correct. Statement 2 is wrong and I gave, ma'am's class mein to discussion hua nahi tha. I gave this as part of our, you know, last moment mein that material I gave to students. Usme bhi tha, theek hai. So, answer is 1 and 3. Moving on, 76. Nomadic elephant. If you look at statement 3, this exercise is aimed to train elephants in defense activities. We are no more using elephants, you know, to fight wars. So on that ground, option A, option C, dono chala gaya. We left with B and D. And 14th edition took place in 2019, that is correct, and 1 is correct. Okay. So 1 and 2 is correct. And it was covered in current affairs class or test series mein bhi tha ye. Question number 77. The question is asking about Bhatagaika crater. Bhatagaika crater I have covered in our July Ratta 5 series. Bhatagaika crater tha. Aur test series mein bhi hai. PT29 test series, Ratta 5 test series mein bhi diya gaya tha. Here the answer is 1 and 3. Bhatagaika crater, and they are asking which of them are not correct. Okay. That you have to pay attention. Statement 1 is not correct. Statement 3 is not correct. I think it is known as gateway to underworld. Question number 78. Talisman Sabre exercise 2023. It was again July month ka current affairs tha. They have asked it and it is between Australia and USA. Series mein bhi maine diya tha. Your answer is 214. It is a joint military exercise of two countries. That is correct. India attended as an observer. Ye ek solution mein maine diya tha. Okay. It is between Australia and USA. 78. 79. Rajasthan Minimum Guaranteed Income Bill 2023. I have not asked this in our test series, but ma'am has covered in her current affairs classes elaborately, and the answer here is 79. Answer kya hai? 1 and 3. That is C. Question number 80. Multidimensional Poverty Index. Again, that same material that I gave, you know, just 2-3 days before exam. Only 60 items maybe. I don't think 60 items were there. 40 maybe. But not 40, less than 40, I think. Okay. So if you look here, multidimensional poverty index, 13.5 crore people escaped multidimensional poverty. That is correct. Ye hamara Ratta 5 magazine mein bhi hai. That is correct statement. Rural area mein exact statement is there here. You can see here, rural area. Okay. So yes, statement 1 is correct, statement 2 is correct. But here the question is asking us which of them are not correct. So obviously 1 and 2, if they are correct, 3 and 4 are incorrect, so go for 3 and 4. Done. 81. Which of the state government has launched this particular scheme called educational initiative called CM Rise Schools? That is Madhya Pradesh gave in our test series. 82. Which of the following statements are correct in respect of agreement on use of local currency? In news mein tha, I didn't give it as a, you know, test series. Test mein nahi pucha tha maine, but here the answer is 1 and 2, C, 82, C. 83, it is asking about NAMDA project. Okay, I didn't ask in our test series, but ma'am has covered as part of our current affairs classes, weekly current affairs classes. So in that one, NAMDA belongs to Kashmir. 2200 candidates from Assam were trained. No, there is 2,200 candidates from Jammu Kashmir or Kashmir were trained. So statement 2 is wrong, rest of the things are right. Answer is 83B. 84. This is the difficult part, and I think it is better, you know, if you leave these questions if you have not read them thoroughly. And another thing is these things usually read by history optional students. Okay, let's begin. The Bhumagara started an era in the year 736 AD. Here the answer is C, 204. 85, Vanjas of Khinjali Mandal. Yeah, this was a mains question, history mains question tha last year. Okay. And if you know, for Vanjas, Vanjanagar was the most important city or capital. But you might not be knowing the ancient name of Vanjanagar, that is Vanjulvaka. Okay. 85A. 86, Mahasivagupta Balarjuna. If you see, look at the statements. Statement 2 is wrong. Okay. Rest of the statements are correct, so only 2 are correct. 87. This is about creation of the Odisha province. Exact statements are given over here. If you compare this, you know, both two, all the statements that is given in the question is here. Okay. It talks about the constitution of Odisha Order 1936. It talks about John Austin Hubbuck becoming the first governor of India. It talks about Sir Country Terrell, who is administering the oath to the new governor. Also, the inaugural function, which is celebrated at Revensha College, Cuttack. So, all of the 4 things are correct. But then again, this is fact-heavy, and I think most of the students may not have attended. Mahatma Gandhi visited Odisha. See, if you want to go for a calculated risk over here, we know that in 1930, Gandhi was in Yerwada jail. Okay. So he was lodged in jail, so how come he can visit Odisha? So if you eliminate that one, you will have, you know, only 3. This is a calculated risk you have to take. He came 7-8 times to Odisha, so who will remember all that? 89. Kapilendra Dev subdued many feudatory chiefs. Okay. Which of the following did not belong to this category? Chauhan Chab Patna to Isha Gosnaida, Chauhan Chab Sambalpur was there. Okay, so that's why 89B is the wrong one. 90, not correct. The answer is A. 90, answer is A. 91. We did a Buddhist heritage of Odisha to make video. We did it. So in that we talked about Ratnagiri, Udayagiri, Lalitgiri, Pushpagiri and all that. Here the answer is Madhavapur Mahavihara is located at Udayagiri. 92. Okay, if you look at the question, Odisha history class may we cover it, but not in test series. Okay, we have not covered it as part of test series. Mains se pehle we gave Odisha related material. So in that these things will be there. Answer here is 92C. Odisha related history things were difficult this year. Subai, Kuchala, Jamuda, all the 3 sites of Koraput are related to Jain. These are, you know, ancient Jain relics. 93A is the answer. 94. This is an easy one. Ancient India one. India class chal raha hai. Ancient India test series mein bhi ek pucha gaya tha. Not exactly in so many words, but yeah, Saraswati Nadi Dharma Jit Rai. It mentions Aryans as a cultural community. It has many commonalities with Jindavesta or Avesta. It mentions Saraswati as Naritarnath. All of them are correct. It indicates that the Dashyus kept cattle for dairy products. See, Dashyus were nothing but the early Aryans who came and settled over, you know, in say Punjab region and all. Then another huge group of Aryans came. And for them, this group of people, the early Aryan settlers, became, you know, Dashyus. And we know that the Aryans came from, you know, a Central Asian region, and they came from a pastoral land. They are essentially pastoralist. That means their affinity was with the cattle. So the Dashyus definitely had cattle. So all of them are correct. 95. Okay. It is about Parthians. Maybe 10 days before I just finished this class, Ancient India class chal raha tha. They had migrated from Iran, correct. They set up a kingdom in East India. Nahi, itne andar tak nahi jayenge wo. Mundaferles was a Parthian king. Because they will come through northwest protected province, and going to eastern India is little difficult. Okay. So 2 is wrong, 3 is right. fourth is right, one is right. 1, 3, 4 is the answer. 95. 96. This is about Sangam literature. Interestingly, couple of days before only this, I was taking this class. Maybe 4-5 days before. Not 4-5 days, 3-4 days before. Okay. So that is the screenshot that Sangam corpus. Narrative are called, you know, the narrative texts are called Melkanaku, they are also 18 major works. The didactic texts are called Kilkanaku or 18 minor works. Then Thirukkural is a major Sangam work. No, yahan pe agar aap screenshot mein bhi dekhoge, Thirukkural is a minor work. So statement 3 is wrong, rest of them are right. So 1 to 4 is the answer. 97 ye culture class mein main cover karta hu. I have not asked this as part of test series though. Mughavars, Pampa, Nanaya, Punna, all that, you know, poets, their work, etc. So all of them are correct though. Again, Ancient India class mein ye cover hua hai. Test mein it is also covered. Buddhism was patronized by Pado kings because they have built, you know, so many viharas or universities. So yes, that is correct. Buddha was worshipped as a god in Mahayana Buddhism. According to Mahayana Buddhism, Buddha was not an ordinary man. He was a god. He was a divine. If you look at statement 3, from Hinayana's perspective, Buddha was just a man, human being, but an extraordinary one. Okay. So that is the difference between Mahayana's understanding of Buddha and Hinayana's understanding of Buddha. So 1, 2, 3. 3 of the statements are correct. Vajrayana focused on Hindu practices. Yes. Vajrayana means vehicle of thunderbolt. So it was associated with, you know, Indra. It is associated with a deity, female deity called Tara. Okay. So tantric elements are there, Vajrayana. So Hindu practice, ritual, sacrifice, all those things are there. So yes, all of them are correct. About Alauddin Khalji, and I have given so many questions on, you know, Alauddin Khalji. Medieval India classes mein toh ye sab cover hota hai. If you specifically look at question statement number 3, the peasant had to pay land revenue in kind. No, he was also allowed to pay in cash. What's the, you know, why there was so much of a restriction? There was no such thing. So statement 3 is wrong. Then you have your answer. 99C. Question number 100. Subsidiary Alliance, Modern India class, test series mein bhi shayad maine pucha tha. Modern India, we didn't focus much this year, although I gave, you know, some questions. Answer will be D, 100D, 1 and 3. So this concludes the whole analysis. If you look at the paper broadly, it was polity heavy, but the polity questions, you know, not easy. It was geography heavy, but certain geography questions were not that easy. Odisha history was untouchable. You cannot do that at all. Okay, if you have not read in depth I can say with certainty that the people with history optional cannot even do those questions with 100% accuracy. That's not going to happen anytime soon. So yes, and apart from that, some commonsensical questions were there, two invalid questions were there, and I think one question where, you know, both two of the options were correct. So margin of error was less, but economy question tha, but it was not a dominant factor. Environment question tha, but was not a dominant factor. Geography was a dominant factor. Polity was an extremely dominant factor. And to look at the whole scheme of things, they haven't asked, you know, the major questions that should have been asked. They could have made it difficult, that's okay. But they have not asked many important questions as well. Okay. And they are, you know, focusing. So that means they are, you know, trying to play cat and mouse game with him, with the aspirants. Kind of questions are there. I can predict that public art question paper, optional paper questions will be difficult, history optional question paper will be difficult, so on and so forth. But nonetheless, let's not jump into conclusions. And cutoff is going to be very low this year, that much I can predict. And to arrive at a scientific cutoff, the way we do it every year. So I am giving a link below. In that link, there is a form, you fill up the form. Once we collect say 500-600 data of good students, we can have an idea ki what is the overall performance of students, so that we can arrive at a, you know, near exact cutoff. Okay. For the past 3-4 years, I think we have gave near exact, you know, cutoffs. So we'll try to do that to try to have a, you know, scientific approach towards the cutoff as well. I know a lot of you are in anxiety. Don't be anxious now. Go through the question. Don't think or overthink it. Whatever you have done, it is over now. So look for the next thing that you are going to do. Best of luck and thank you.